When the Big 12 began in 1996, it looked like the strength was in the North. After all, in 95, four teams that would play in the league's Northern Division finished in the top 10. And when Nebraska took home the 1997 National Championship, it further entrenched this division as the dominant one. The Aggies crossed paths with the Big Red Machine on their run to the title that year.
They beat us pretty handily. That was a very good Nebraska team. After the game in San Antonio, the media says, you know, how long do you think it'll take you to, you know, the South to ever catch up to the North?
The Huskers' 54-15 whipping of A&M in the Alamo Dome was the North's 13th win in 19 contests against the South in 1997. When 98 got going, the Huskers weren't stopping. Hoping to defend their championship, they were 5-0 and ranked number 2 when they arrived at Kyle Field on October 10th.
To see them come in, having won the national title in 1997, having blown out A&M in that 97 title game, there was a lot of anticipation. Could A&M, you know, hang with these guys?
In what was the first maroon out in history, the Aggies looked to stop the Sea of Red's tidal wave of momentum. The Huskers had won 19 games in a row, more than anyone in the nation at that time. A&M was 4-1 and ranked 18th. But none of their wins were very impressive. But at Kyle, on this day, Texas A&M played inspired football.
Just that perfect college football day here in College Station, and for the Aggies to just play an incredible defensive ball game. I mean, they stifled that high-powered Nebraska option offense.
First man.
That Jamar Toombs run, that to me was, that's what I'll always remember about that game.
I remember the offensive line, that they controlled the line of scrimmage, and you just didn't do that against Nebraska.
The Aggies were clinging to a 28-21 lead late in the fourth quarter. A tired but relentless wrecking crew had to dig deep and clamp down one more time.
Snap it, drop it back to the 32, dancing around, intercepted, Texas A&M, and that'll be Curry. Folks, this ball game is over with the exception of 51 seconds.
The Aggies had done it. They had beaten a team that had won three of the previous four national titles. The A&M victory also meant redemption.
It was so gratifying, not only to beat them in a big game, but because of what all had been said the year before about the disparity in the North zone and the South zone and the difference between A&M and Nebraska. And in talking to the team, we closed that gap pretty fast.
The Aggies completed their run a month and a half later when they beat the North's representative, Kansas State, in the Big 12 championship game in St. Louis. The 1998 season signaled change in this brand new conference, and it was the Aggies who were instrumental in ushering it in with a couple of strikes of the sword that slayed a couple of Northern giants.
It was significant for me, and I think for our fans, that we were in a major conference, and we were not only competing, we beat those teams.